Charlie and my wonderful friend Gort. Say hello, Gort.
Hello, Mr. Charlie. I am doing quite well, I must say.
And how is everyone tonight? Well, we have a wonderful movie for you tonight. Tonight we have the 1940 Boris Karloff classic, The Ape. So you know tonight we're going to be monkeying around all night. It's sure to be bananas. And we'll have a bunch of monkey surprises all night, isn't that right, Gort?
That is correct, Mr. Charlie. I have a special surprise interview with a film legend later on in the show, but I assure you it will be a very memorable night, I must say.
We're all just going apey. Now, how about we get this party started? Are you ready, Gort? Well, I'm ready. You know what time it is. The theater's filling, but there's room right up front with me. Grab your blanket, grab your popcorn, let the horrible old movie begin.
Tires I got them riding on.
We got enough money to go to the circus, but not enough for the sideshow.
Money. Plenty of freaks around here.
Hey, you think they got all the things they say they have?
Sure, the man took.
Bet they ain't got no lions.
They have to. The man let us see them.
He did?
Bet they ain't got teeth.
Sure they have, long as anything.
Let you and me go see them.
You can go ahead. We're going swimming.
Hey, we're going past Adrian's house, ain't we?
Sure.
Sure. What's the matter, you skip?
I ain't scared of no crazy doctor.
Well, if you're coming, come on.
Wait, you see, it's this way. I don't get home for dinner, why? Mom won't let me go to the circus.
All right, so you're afraid. Well, you'd better stay here.
Do something about Doc Adrian. Destroying all the values in this town. Giving Red Creek a bad name.
I think so. You're right, Mason.
Run out of this town a long time ago.
Who ought to be run out of the town?
Dr. Adrian.
You should have been with us this afternoon. He's scared the women so bad they haven't got over it yet.
This town's too healthy. Maybe he'd scare himself a couple of patients. Understand them big doctors make a lot of money on nervous women.
Well, it's funny when that hemic broke out, Quinn. You know as well as I do, he used a lot of those patients as guinea pigs.
I know nothing of the sort. I know he did everything he could.
Two or three in this town, I wouldn't agree to that. However, I can understand his reason for want of patience now.
Well, he got himself another this afternoon.
Little Willie over there.
He ran after me, hurt me, and I wasn't doing nothing. Poor child.
I think you're all yellow.
He's right, and none of you got the courage to do anything about it. His patients die on him, and now he's hanging around Miss Clifford's house experimenting with Francis, I guess.
You make a poor critic, Mason. Your greed hasn't done this town any good.
You doing preaching?
Little preaching wouldn't do you no harm. What with the people you squeeze dry and the usury you charge on your loans?
Oh, I don't ask him to borrow.
There's an answer for that also. But I think it wasted on you.
Business is business, Quinn, and you know it. Besides, we weren't talking about me.
Why don't we kick the doctor out and be done with it?
I'm ready. Time you're willing to start it.
Oh, yes, that prescription on the second. Been quite busy this morning.
I'm sorry to delay you, Doctor.
Perfectly all right. I can fix it myself.
It's none of my business, and maybe we men of science think different from other people, but if they ever find out in the village what you've been doing...
You mean about the animal?
Yes, some of the dogs have been missed.
Well, that phase of the experiment is all over. I've found out all I need to know.
Can I help you?
Do you think they need you in the store?
Just as you say, Doctor, just as you say.
Good. Enjoying the last of the sun.
Okay, sit down.
Thank you. Oh, how's my girl today? Well, you're all dressed up.
Danny phoned. He's coming over.
So early?
We can't hide. He's going to the circus.
Oh, yes, sir. I almost forgot. I've got a present for you, Fran.
Oh, for me, Doctor?
Well, I'm too excited. If you wait till you open it. It isn't anything at all,
though. Oh, Doctor. Oh, it's beautiful. But why so much, Doctor? You gave me a birthday last month.
So I did. Well, this is a make-believe birthday, just a daughter.
Was she very like me?
She'd have been just 18 today. She was to have worn that. I couldn't save her, and I couldn't save her mother. I had weapons to fight the disease that killed them, but I have now, or at least I've got a knowledge of them. 10 years it's taken. Frances, we're going to walk again.
You're so intense, you frighten me sometimes.
So Danny's going to the circus?
Yes. Then he's coming back here afterwards and tell me all about it.
Oh, he is he? Well, why don't you go with him?
Oh, me?
Do you think she
you're
could?
Fooling.
Why, of course she could. I don't know why she shouldn't.
Hello, everybody.
Oh, Danny.
Danny.
Hello, Mrs. Clifford.
Well, Danny, where would you like to take Frances to the circus?
Gee, that'd be great, only...
Well, of course she can go. We can take care of her. I'll be back for you later.
Well, thanks, Doctor.
Now, don't you worry, Mrs. Clifford. Two strong men to look after her. She'll be all right. Be back later.
Bye, Doctor. Danny, I think you'd better run home and get yourself cleaned up. You look as if you'd brought all of the grease from the garage with you.
You know, Francis, I think the doc's crazy. I suppose I'll have to like him as long as he's nice to you.
He wants to be nice to everybody, but people won't let him.
Well, I'm not saying I believe all the things.
Don't you believe any of the things they say about him, Danny Foster?
Well, all right, don't get excited.
Look, Danny, the stories they tell about the doctor are just as dirty as the grease on your hands and face.
Bob takes care of me. So long, honey.
Goodbye, Danny.
Right. Okay. Well, this next year, it'll take 3 men to lift you.
Oh, not 3 men, Doctor. If it did, they'd want a circus.
I'll be else at the circus to help you lift her down.
What's the matter? Aren't you coming?
No, you two go on by yourself. Now, you don't mind if I change my mind, do you?
Oh, please, Doctor.
You'll have much more fun together. Off you go. And don't forget to tell me all about it in the morning.
So long,
Doctor.
Come on. Thanks for everything.
Goodbye, Doctor.
Bye.
Bye, Mother.
Bye. Have a good time.
you really see him?
Yeah, in the sideshow. He's a big fella.
Is he bigger than three men?
That ape is bigger than six men. Six big men.
It's the biggest ape gorilla in the whole world.
Look, here come the clowns.
Having a good time?
Yes.
You don't act like it.
Gee, everybody's looking at us. I'm nervous.
What for?
Well, out with a married man and, you know.
Gee, this is the best circus I ever saw.
The only circus I've ever seen.
She's not so hot. I saw her pass Nick this morning. Them costumes make a big difference.
That's what the doctor calls muscular grace. Muscular coordination.
Honey, look over in that ring there. See?
You'll be chasing bones in the morning. What I've done for you, I could do for men. They'd let me.
That's all, honey.
I'm sorry it's over.
We'll never miss another circus.
Drive that animal crazy?
Well, he's getting mean. It's the only way I can handle him.
You ever try a little kindness? Nothing wrong with him. Nabu. Come here, Nabu, old boy.
Come on, Nabu. That's it.
Yeah, well, 2 years ago, he killed my old man. And I ain't gonna let him forget it, understand?
I know he did. I was right here when he did it. Because he was abusing him, same as you're doing. If you don't watch your step, he gets you, too. Why don't you mind your own business? You boys wouldn't be gambling, would you?
Oh, no.
Sheriff, take me in.
There was a fine show you fellas put on. You was the funniest clown I ever seen.
Oh, I rode a horse. He was the clown.
He was?
Yeah.
Oh, he looks like a judge.
Hey, Jim, Pete, let's give him a hand. Come on.
Teresa and get something to put him on. We'll take him there.
Come on, man. Somebody better get after that apron and tear this town wide open.
Pete, get a posse together.
Come on, boys. Let's see what we can do about that fire.
All right.
So we got some monkeys in the studio today. Can you believe that? I guess Gort's going to interview a monkey or something. I don't know what's going on, but we have like 12 monkeys in the studio. I don't know if you can hear them behind me freaking out. Yeah, ow, ow, yeah. They're throwing things. They're disturbing everybody. It's getting pretty crazy around here, people. But the show must go on, and so must my horrible joke. Hey, monkeys, I got a joke for you. What do you call a monkey who sells potato chips? A chipmunk! What do you call a monkey in a minefield? A baboon! Oh, I don't think they're liking the jokes, Gort. They're getting pretty riled up.
Yes, I think your jokes are upsetting them.
I don't care. I'm going to do more. Here's another one. What do you call a baby monkey? A chimp off the old block! Where do monkeys go to have a drink? Monkey bars! No, they don't seem to like that, Gort. Hey, monkey. Hey, yeah, you. Why don't monkeys play cards in the jungle? Because there are too many cheetahs there. Ah, he didn't like that. He threw something at me. That better have been a candy bar. How many monkeys has it take to screw in a light bulb, Gort? 3. 1 to screw in the light bulb and 2 to throw poo at each other. Hey, did you hear about the man that can jump from tree to tree? He was a monkey's uncle. Oh, watch out, Gort, you're getting crazy.
Watch out, Mr. Charlie. They are swarming.
And you know you should never pick a fight with the monkeys. Because they use guerrilla warfare. Oh, I'm sorry. They don't seem to like these jumps, people. But I've got a few more. So, where should a monkey go when he loses his tail? To a retailer! I know these jokes are horrible. Why couldn't a monkey eat the banana? Because the banana split! Alright, folks, I think we better get back to a horrible old movie. But first, a word with Gort.
Hello everyone and welcome to a special part of the show. I have the star of over 20 motion pictures and countless cable specials, Mr. Gilbert the Monkey. We welcome you to our humble show.
Yeah, well thanks for having me. My name's Gilbert. I'm a bonobo monkey, if you cannot tell. Although my grandfather was part orangutan. Yeah.
Well, thanks for having me. I'm glad to be here. Well, I'm in a couple documentaries on National Geographic, of course. And I've been in a couple major motion pictures, like Jumanji. And I'm always a body double for Mark Wahlberg. Yes, I knew you recognized me. And tonight's movie seems pretty good. We're all fans of Boris Karloff. And his portrayal of a monkey wasn't that bad. He looks like my Uncle Artie. Yeah, he's serving time. The Michigan Zoo.
So, Mr. D. Monkey, would you like to answer some questions on the big Sasha Gray film scandal?
Now, you stop asking me those kind of questions or we're gonna have a problem.
My bad.
I'm just saying.
Well, can you at least tell us if the baby is yours?
Now, that's enough. All right, boys. Poo flinging time.
Oh no, folks, looks like things are getting out of hand here in the studio. How about we get back to our horrible old movie?
Badly hurt. Sorry to bother you, Doctor. Bring him in here. Come on, right here, Moody.
Well, what happened?
An ape got him.
An ape? Hope we scared him off in time.
This man's badly mauled. Well, you better get him into my laboratory. Jane, you show them. Well, now, how did it happen? Was he in the cage with the ape?
No, the circus burned down and the ape escaped.
The circus burned down? And the audience?
They'd all gone home.
Oh, thank heaven for that.
Will you want us any further, Doctor?
No, I'll take care of it.
Well, then, come on, boys. Let's get out and see if we can find that ape.
Don't let him get at me, mister. Don't let him get at me.
Perfectly safe here. I'm a doctor.
Am I hurt bad, Doc?
I'm afraid so.
I don't feel nothing. Am I going to die?
We all have to die sometime.
Oh, just don't let me die, Doc.
Man. The highest kind of animal.
Hey, Doc, what are you going to do with me?
I'm going to write you into medical history. I'm going to keep a promise.
Wait here. Keep your eyes open.
That sheriff ain't got no heart. I'm so hungry I could eat hay.
Well, there's a barn full. Help yourself. And search the country up around Carter's farm. Jim, you take your boys and cover the west side of town. Pete, you stay with me.
All right.
How about joining us, Mason?
Let the circus people do their own work. Why should we do it for them?
But the circus is burned down. They've had trouble enough.
Oh, that's their tough luck.
Well, if we don't find that ape, our own people might get hurt.
That's your job. Your law and order. Why should I worry about other people? They don't worry about me.
You wouldn't be a little bit scared, would you, Mason?
Well, don't be all day about it. We're ready.
It gives a body the creeps to think of that critter roaming around.
Better keep the doors and windows all barred. No telling who we'll go for next.
Are you all right, dear?
Mm-hmm.
Want some more? What you thinking about?
I was thinking about that wonderful woman aerialist I saw last night.
Oh, here comes Dr. Adrian.
Morning, Mrs. Griffith.
Good morning.
Francis?
Oh, good morning, Dr. Adrian. I want to thank you again for the wonderful time I had last night. It was too bad about that trainer, wasn't it?
Now, don't you think about him. This is the most important day in your life. Today, we are really going to start her cure. I found the serum that I need.
I'm going to walk, Dr. Adrian.
I hope so. I'm not just thinking about you, Francis, but of all the other sufferers in the world, all the little boys and girls who can't go out into the sunshine and play and have fun, who have to spend their lives in a wheelchair like you.
I'll do anything I can, Dr. Adrian.
I know you will, my dear. It's not going to be easy. It's going to hurt. But when it hurts, don't be afraid. Just remember that when the pain is gone, it'll leave new life behind. Huh? I think we better get her ready.
All right, Doctor.
Now we've got him here and there and here. Now, if we don't get any results tonight, we'll start in here and work west.
Oh, change your mind, Mr. Mason?
I never change my mind.
You gotta have one first.
That's enough out of you. Here's that dispossess notice on Wilcox. I want it served tonight.
We're busy tonight. It'll wait till tomorrow.
Your duty is to take care of the citizens of this town. Not fooling around chasing apes.
It seems you're in a mighty big hurry to make people uncomfortable, Mason.
It's my business what I do.
Fine, and it's mine what I do.
We'll get to...
Oh, Doctor.
Well, sis?
Oh, my legs. They feel like lead. I can't lift them.
But you never could lift them before.
Oh, I know, but I never felt them before.
You feel them, Frances? You feel them?
They're so heavy.
Well, that's good news, my dear. That's what we were hoping for. It's only just the beginning. If there's any change, you send for me immediately.
Yes, Doctor.
Oh, Mother.
Jane. Jane!
Look, I succeeded. It's there. Life in that tiny bottle. It's working. The child will walk again.
Just go.
Get a doctor.
It ain't no good. He's been dead for hours.
Well, let's notify the sheriff.
What?
Dr. Adrian is really going to cure me.
What if they hurt you? How can you be getting better?
Oh, you don't understand, Danny. They never hurt before. There was no feeling at all. Now they feel alive.
Just the same, I don't like it. I like things I can't understand.
Well, I don't understand either, Danny, but I believe in you. Oh, I have so much faith in him, Danny. He says I'm like a daughter to him, and, well, I know he wouldn't hurt me unless he had to. It's part of the cure. It's just got to be.
All right. I'll try to believe, too. But I'd rather carry around all my life and have anything happen to you.
Sheriff, any luck?
Not yet, but we'll get him.
Well, I hope so.
Come on, boy. Come on. There, it looks like they picked up a scent.
Come along, Sheriff. All right, give him a minute, right?
Well, what got into him? Hold on. Come on for a minute, will you?
Yeah, you
betcha. Hello, Doc. I haven't seen anything of that ape, have you? Oh,
no, I haven't, Sheriff.
Well, my dogs just acted as if they'd picked up his scent.
Oh. Well, I better be careful.
Yeah, you better be. Having trouble with insects, Doc?
Yes. This is just a little mixture of my own I'm trying to get rid of them with.
Well, if it works, let me know. My yard's full of them.
It will.
Thanks.
Ready. Are you going out?
Yeah.
But I made lamb stew and dumplings.
I don't care for lamb stew and dumplings, thank you. Besides, the sheriff wants us out early to capture that ape.
You needn't lie. I know where you're going.
Oh, you do?
Yes, everybody does.
So you've been listening to gossip, eh?
I can't keep people from talking to me and telling me you found a new interest.
Suppose I have.
Well, there's nothing I can do about it, I guess.
Well, keep that in mind.
But if you just wouldn't carry on here where we live, so people would stop pitying me, even if you'd go somewhere else.
Why don't you try going somewhere else?
But I have no one but you. I have no folks. I've got no place to go.
You've got the river.
What makes you think you're
Well, boys, did you get yourselves some rest today?
About 40 winks, we're plumb burnt out.
Well, maybe we can get some more people to help us out.
Why don't we
come out in the daytime? The circus people told us we never. We got to catch him prowling after dark.
Think he's still hanging around the village?
He got Mason, didn't he? And we found new tracks up around Dr. Adrian's house. Oh, give me a sarsaparilla.
What do you think of that, Sheriff? Even the dogs don't like him.
Well, it got into him
way around his house.
Don't make sense.
Maybe it's because the doc looks so much like an ape himself.
This is no time for joking. All of you be on the job tonight.
Hey, folks, welcome back. I hope you're enjoying tonight's horrible old movie. You know what time of the night it is, folks. It's intermission time. Time to grab a nice cold drink and use the bathroom and meet us here in just a few minutes.
Hey, Mom. Yes, you. Why fuss and fret about dinner? Why not have it right here? Yes, this drive-in offers everyone in the family a real picnic treat for dinner. We've got delicious sandwiches with all the trimmings and your other dinner favorites, plus whatever you want to drink, hot or cold. Come early before the show starts, or eat while you're being entertained, or at intermission time. So why fuss? Give your family a tasty dinner at this drive-in.
What is it?
Hey, why, it's Buttercup. Popcorn, add some butter to hot popcorn. Mix it up, wrap it up, Buttercup is born.
It's delicious.
So nutritious.
It's a taste delight.
It's so munchy.
Crisp and crunchy.
You'll enjoy each bite. Eat Buttercrunched Buttercup. Popcorn at its best.
Served in a king-size cup.
It beats all the rest.
And just raring to go. First, Wahoo and his mighty syncopators with their boiling rhythm. Hot tunes from the very heart of jungle land. He's pounding hot, hard and high. Hot weather never bothers this chimp drummer boy. Light heads and light feet now get to work. The jumping jingo's hot foot specialty means chimp heat at its hottest. Gee, what a face. But here's a customer that likes the show. Now we have a jungle chic Munko, and do we see his little brother, too? Please, Munko, go home and get your manners.
And now, ladies and gentlemen, on all continents, the finale, the grand finale, the speediest performing monkey in all the world, the acrobat of acrobats, the leap for life and a peanut. What? No peanut this time. Well, this time we're lucky, alley-oop.
Alright, folks, how about we get back to our horrible old movie, The Ape?
I'm scared, Mrs. Clifford. She looks almost... I'm really scared.
We must trust Dr. Adrian.
But we don't know. He ain't got a patient in this town. People don't just hate a fellow for nothing.
Do you hate him, Danny?
No. It's not hating him, it's... loving Frances the way I do. If anything happens to her, I'm going down to see. I gotta ask him. I gotta know.
Danny? Danny's worried, isn't he, Mother?
Now you just rest here. Danny'll be all right.
Oh, my legs didn't hurt so. I'm not afraid. You aren't, are you, Mother?
No, darling. I want my little girl to walk again.
You ain't going in there, Doc.
Now, what is this, Danny?
I'm scared about her. I got to know what you're doing.
Well, surely you want her to live a normal life like other people.
Well, sure, as long as nothing happens to her. I love her just the way she is, Doc. I can take care of her. I want to take care of her. I don't want no experimenting on her.
But, Danny, if through her I could rid the world of...
I'm not in love with the world. I'm in love with her. I get it. She's just a guinea pig to you. Well, you got to stop it. You got to stop hurting her.
Have you been to your garage today?
No, I ain't. I've been too worried.
Well, you take care of your cars, and I'll take care of my patients. Now, just you run along.
I ain't running no place. I ain't no doctor. And I don't know enough about what you're doing. But if anything happens to Francis...
Nothing's going to happen to Francis. Now, don't interfere.
Doctor. How do you do, Dr. Adrian?
And how is my patient feeling this morning?
I'm all right. She's been in great pain, doctor.
In pain? Well, that's good.
Good?
Of course it is. That's what we're looking for. Now, you prepare her. Work.
You say the name is Mason?
Yeah. Yes, doctor. Initial H. Anything in your examination to go into my report?
No, I believe not.
Well, I just said the death was caused by a fractured vertebrae. I guess that about covers it, doesn't it?
Yes, I should say that it would.
The reason I sent for you, doctor, is because you examined the circus trainer when he was sent north. And this case being a similar one to that, I thought probably in your examination that you had discovered something that I had overlooked to put in my coroner's report.
I see. This Dr. Adrian, whose name is on the death certificate, is he the local physician?
Yes, if you can call him one. Folks around here don't like him much, though.
And he was also called in on the case of the trainer?
Yes. Yes, that's the same fellow. He came here during the paralysis epidemic. But the folks around here say that he experiments too much.
Thank you very much, Coroner. I believe you've given me all the information necessary.
That's fine, Nelson.
Oh. Oh.
Francis, what do you feel?
My legs.
They're hurting?
Oh, they hurt terrible.
Have you more sensation than you had yesterday?
Oh, yes, much more.
Do you think perhaps you could walk?
Oh, no.
Then try to move your foot.
Oh, I can't.
You can. Try.
No.
You can.
No.
You can.
No.
You can.
Oh. Oh, Mother. Oh.
Lucky.
Oh.
Now you rest. You rest. I'll be back later.
Mother, I know I'll be able to walk again.
I know, baby. I know.
Dr. Adrian?
That's right.
I'm Dr. McNulty from the Robinson Foundation.
Oh, yes.
I had occasion to examine the body of a circus trainer who was killed by an ape here in this town.
Yes, sir.
I understand that you administered to the wounded man before he died.
I did my best for him, but it was quite hopeless.
In spite of the spinal injection you gave him?
I gave him no injection.
I just came from viewing the body of this man, Mason, and I noticed a similar spinal puncture. Did you examine him also?
Well, they called me in, of course, but it was too late. He was dead.
And you noticed no such puncture?
Well, the body was so badly mangled that... Well, no, I didn't.
I see. I understand they've had an epidemic of paralysis here.
That's true.
Many years ago, the Robinson Foundation found it necessary to expel from the institution a most promising young research worker because of his daring, unorthodox experiments with spinal fluid.
It was 25 years ago, to be exact.
Then you are that Dr. Bernard Adrian? whose definite theories...
And in spite of what you did to me, for 25 years, I've been engaged in proving those theories.
By what method have you been doing this?
I'm not in a position to disclose it.
I see. Well, I'm afraid you leave me no alternative but to report...
Wait. If I could give you some small measure of proof, would you change your mind?
I doubt it.
Let me show you. Now, these two creatures were completely paralyzed. But after my treatment, well, you can see for yourself, they're as lively and healthy as ever they were.
All this has nothing to do with the case.
But it has. The serum that I used...
What became of the serum you took from those two men?
Now, you come with me. Clifford. Now, this is Dr. McNulty.
How do you do, Doctor?
He'd like to talk to Frances.
She's asleep.
No, I'm not asleep, Mother.
Hello, Frances.
Hello.
Now, this child has had a complete paralysis of her lower limbs for 10 years. Is that right, Mrs. Clifford?
Yes, it's Doctor.
Have you had any feeling at all in your limbs since, Dr. Adrian has been treating you?
Yes, they've been terribly heavy, and I've had a great deal of pain.
Pain?
Yes, and just a little while ago, I moved my foot.
Is that right?
That's right.
Will you do it again for me?
I can't.
Make an effort.
I can't.
Thank you. That's all.
Is anything wrong, Doctor?
Why, no, Frances, dear. Of course not.
Well, her foot did not move. But I did feel a definite muscular reflex. Congratulations. May I notify the Foundation that you come back to us?
Too late. I have to stay here.
At least give me your promise to keep us informed of your progress.
Every step of the way.
Thank you.
He's always leading my little Willie astray.
Well, he's always under Mickey's heel.
Oh, he's nothing
to do. Ladies, we've got work to do. Your kids are just someplace where they shouldn't be. That ain't nothing new. Have you looked down in Jones's barn? I caught them smoking there last week.
We've searched the whole town.
Go take a look for them, Pete. They ain't far away.
Sheriff! Sheriff!
Where have you been?
Mr. Minimoff, we got him!
What is it?
Mickey killed him. He shot him dead. Bang, bang, between the eyes.
Hold it, kid. What'd you shoot him with, Mickey?
My 22. I got a good beat on him.
Where's your 22, Mickey?
He dropped it, Sheriff.
I did not. The ape grabbed it.
I'll ape you when I get you home.
Aw, gee, Ma, don't you believe us?
Where'd you see him?
On the pike about a quarter mile from Doc Adrian's house.
All right, get him home.
Come on, Mickey.
Come on,
Willie.
Come on,
Willie.
Come on,
Willie.
Come on,
Willie.
Come on, get out.
They probably shot a cow. Yeah. I look into it. Where are the dogs?
Red's got them over on the other side of town.
All right, let's go.
Wait a minute, boys. I want a word with the doctor. I'll be right out.
Okay.
I wanted to see if you were all right. Ain't been out, have you?
No.
I'm trying to think out, Doctor, a lot of things. That ape seems to take a fancy to your place. Now, don't take offense, Doctor. I'm just trying to clear up my mind. Them dogs of mine have been sniffing ape for days. It's made them foolish, I guess. Else why'd they snarl at you?
Well, there may be some chemical odors on my clothes that offended them.
Uh-huh. But I ain't never seen my dogs offended at anything. Can't understand it, Doctor.
Wait a minute. Jane! Just get me that torn coat of the trainer's, will you? Now, this is an idea that's just occurred to me. I don't know whether it makes sense or not, but perhaps it'll explain your problem. You see, this coat was worn by the trainer when he was mauled by the ape, and it's been in the house ever since. Now, that perhaps explains the interest of the ape in this house and your dogs in me.
Leonard, I'll bet you're right. Well, I'll get along. Think I'll put a few men around your house the rest of the night, Doctor, just so you'll be protected.
Don't bother. I'm perfectly safe. They might interfere with some work that I have
to do. Well, maybe I'll just keep an eye out myself. I'm just a bit scared, Doc. But don't tell anybody about it. This is the coat that trainer was wearing when the ape killed him.
Or did he rip that up?
He got it up in a stroke.
One sweat. Well, come on now, boys. This isn't getting us anywhere. If we lay down on this job, our own coats will be in the same shape. Come on, let's get busy. Now, you fellas get back to your positions. You boys go up this way.
All right, sir.
I'll stay here.
Hello, puny earthlings. I hope you are enjoying tonight's horrible old movie. Mr. Charlie and I have gotten most of the monkeys wrangled up. So things are running smooth again, except for all the banana peels they left behind, and other smelly leavings. But anyways, folks, I have something very, very special for your kids. A monkey cartoon, coming right up after this commercial break.
Monkey's uncle.
Yeah, monkey's uncle.
New stunt race day with a monkey business name. Spread the stunts out every place. Make it tough to win the race. Run wild, monkeys, Uncle Why the timer. Run and take the stunt that says be a snake. It's great, monkeys, Uncle Time is going tick, tick, tick. Do a rooster who is sick, cock-a-doodle-choo. Run wild, monkeys, Uncle, hurry, hurry. Do those tricks for the monkeys out of ticks. Run wild, monkeys, Uncle Time. Now's your turn to show your speed. Do more stunts and take the lead. Run wild, monkeys, Uncle, catch a fish and give a toot. Be an owl who cries, woo-hoo. It's fun, monkeys, Uncle Time. Wiggle, waddle, quick, quick, quick. Do the Build-A-Tower trick. 12 stunts, just 3 tries. Case uptized in monkeys' eyes. And you're a monkey's uncle. It's wild! Complete with stunt mats, cards, horns, clickers, tricks, spinner, and monkey timer. From Transigram, where the fun comes from.
Thank you. Thank you.
Now, Francis, dear,
I want you to forget all the hours you've spent in this chair. Put them out of your mind. You're not paralyzed. You never were. Fasten that firmly in your mind. You're not paralyzed. You'll do that for me?
I'll try.
Don't forget. You are not paralyzed. Now then. Move your right leg. Move it. You can.
I can't.
Try.
Stop it, you're hurting
her. I can't, Dr. Adrian.
Try it, Francis. You can. You know you can. Move. There. You moved it, didn't you? You moved it. Now the left one. Now move it. Try again. There! You moved them. You moved them both, didn't you, dear? All right. Stand up and take a step towards me. Do it. It's only your mind holding you in that chair, not your body. Do it, I say. Do it!
You see, I told you.
Go get her some water. Oh, she's all right, Danny. She's better than she was, isn't she? She needs more. Take care of her, Danny. I'll be back.
Oh, Francis, darling. Francis?
Name's Halliday, sheriff over to Red Creek. Had a job finding you.
Well, circus jobs are pretty hard to get, sheriff. Oh, all jobs are kind of scarce. You boys get that ape yet?
That's what I come about.
Didn't get him, huh? Bad, he's a killer.
You boys got some responsibility tracking him down, haven't you?
Well, we did the best we could, Sheriff. The fire broke up the circus. Some of the boys stayed there, didn't they?
Yeah, but that's not what I come about. I just figured when you're looking for something, might help to know its habits. Too many things of this animal I don't understand.
Well, animals is all alike. Lions, elephants, dogs, they all got one-track minds.
What do these gorillas live on?
He ain't killed any animal. Shucks, no, they won't touch an animal except out of meanness. They live on fruits, vegetables.
Well, that's what's bothering me. What's feeding this fellow?
Maybe digging up a garden patch or two or stealing a little bit of fruit.
No signs of it. Checked with all the farmers. Do they prowl around much or do they stick to one place?
Well, a gorilla generally sticks to one place if he's got anything there to keep him.
We see evidence that this fellow's hanging around one place.
Hey, that ape had it in for the trainer. Where'd he die?
In the house of a doctor near the outskirts of town, and that's the place we think the ape's been hanging around. Say, how would he trace the trainer to that house?
Well, sense of smell. They're pretty good at that. Did you bury him in town?
No, we sent his body to his people up north.
That don't give us much, does it? Any of his clothes around?
When that trainer was taken away, his coat was left in the doctor's house. Would that draw the ape there?
It certainly would. You better get rid of him.
I was afraid my time might be wasted coming over here, but I guess it ain't. Thanks very much, Mr. Howley. I better be getting on the road. I'd like to make home around nightfall.
Well, anything I can do for you, let me know.
Boys, go over there by that shrub. Danny, take your men down there 100 yards by that rail fence.
Okay.
Oh, Sheriff, we've been watching there every night, and so far nothing's happened. Now
Will you take orders?
All right.
You two boys go over by Wilcox's barn.
You mean Wilcox's barn?
Yes, Wilcox's barn.
All right.
You two boys go down the road 100 yards. You two wait for me over that stone fence.
All right, Sheriff.
Doctor here? You sure of that? He's not in there.
Sheriff, what's the idea of sticking around so close to the doc's house?
Because that attendant told me that ape would haunt any place where that trainer had been.
Oh.
Hey, what's getting into that, Sheriff? He's getting touchy. Lost his sense of humor. You know, when a man can't laugh, it's just too...
Enjoy it.
Is this where we found the body?
Mm-hmm.
Do apes ever return to the scene of the crime?
They're noted for it.
Well, we got something to look forward to.
What is it? What's the matter? Did you fire that shot?
Yeah. It's Tom. The ape twisted his neck, but Archie knifed him.
Can you walk? Pick him up and carry him to the
dog. All right. Go and get him.
God, he can't be far away. Come on, get out. Get out, you fellas. You boys, come with me.
Francis, I'll see what's happened.
Francis!
Let me give him one, Sheriff.
Hold on, that's enough. He's done.
What are they doing? What are they saying?
Darling, I don't know.
The dog.
All right, boy. Take that off of him.
Let me through. Does the ape hurt him? Let me through! Let me through! Dr. Adrian.
Come to me, child. Walk. Walk.
He's dead, boy.
Oh! Hello, Danny. No, wait, Danny.
Honey, you mustn't overdo it.
I'm doing better every day, Danny.
Oh, sure. You're doing swell, but you got to take it easy. I'll get the chair.
No, Danny. Mother and I burned the chair yesterday. I'm never going to use it again.
Hey, welcome back, folks. I hope you enjoyed tonight's horrible old movie. Good movie, and it's been a pretty good show, huh? What do you think, Gort?
It's been a great show. I'd like to thank the janitorial staff for cleaning the studio after our monkey mishap.
Yeah, besides the mess, it's phenomenal.
It was an excellent show.
I know, and they can meet us here every other Saturday at midnight on Creature Feature Saturday Night Horror Movie. Thanks for watching, and please come to my castle again for the next horrible old movie. Until next time, I'm Mr. Charlie saying good night! Please like, share, and subscribe.